Because we all know what happened this morning. I don't know what that son of a bitch is gonna do next.
So you want to ring the dinner bell for a herd of walkers to show up? How is that better?
Because this place will be fucking chaos when that thing hits. No one will be paying any attention to us. And that's when we go. It's our opening. We just gotta figure out a way to draw them to us.
Your friend here wants to get us killed by lurkers before Bill can do it.
What is it with you?
That's what it sounds like to me.
You know that's not what he's saying, but it does sound dangerous.
Maybe Luke could help us. He's outside. He wants a radio to help keep an eye on the guards.
Thank you. That's the plan I vote for.
You know about Luke?
He flagged us down when Troy wasn't looking. Told us his plan. Mentioned he talked to you.
If Luke can tell us what's going on with the guards, we can use that to pick a good time to escape.
That seems reasonable.
Who knows when that'll be? There was a girl back at Crawford that used church bells to send walkers all over the city. We just need something really loud.
The PA system Carver is always using is quite loud.
There's some speakers outside the building, pointed toward the parking lot. I saw them when we were walking out to the work. Troy's always standing next to one of them.
I saw the controls. They're in Carver's office.
She's right. It's all controlled in Bill's office. There's a switch in there that'll turn them on.
How do you know that?
I used to make a lot of the announcements back in the day. I had it flipped on once. Luckily, there wasn't much around at the time to hear it. It was plenty loud, though.
That's perfect. We just gotta get into his office. Why didn't you say something sooner?
Because it doesn't change anything. This isn't a discussion about how to do it. It's a discussion about whether it's stupid. And it's still stupid. The sensible thing is to get Luke the radio and wait for an opening.
You're real difficult to deal with sometimes.
We should get the radio to Luke. It doesn't hurt to have more information.
I agree.
Fine. We can do that. But the herd is still what's gonna get us out of here. Maybe Luke can tell us where it's hitting from. Okay, so we get that turd radio. He keeps us posted on the herd's movement. We fire up the PA thing and bring the walkers to roll over this place.
And then what?
Get some guns and shoot our way out. I don't know. Whatever we can. We improvise.
Then that's not a plan. You don't plan to improvise.
I figured out what your problem is. You don't think this stuff through. If the end of the plan is just to stroll through a herd of walkers, then you should know from the jump there's no way it's ever going to work.
Actually, I do it all the time.
First words I ever hear you say, and it's just some crazy, stupid shit.
Hush. What do you mean exactly?
When you cover yourself in their smell, rub the walker guts all over you. They can't tell you from one of them.
Now I don't know who's crazier.
Trust me. I've walked through herds before. It works. You just have to keep calm and make sure you're good and covered.
You seem to know what you're talking about.
This is nuts.
Lee figured that out.
What?
It's how we got out of the Marsh house. Lee covered me and we walked right through.
Really? Holy shit. Oh, good one, Lee. All right, what are we waiting for? Let's get that stupid radio.
We still have to find a way to get in the stockroom.
I got a plan for that, too. Come on, kid. Gonna need your help.
Where the hell'd she come from?
We just need to use the winch. She can just climb up from there. Then, just drop into one of the skylights over the stockroom. There are shelves and stuff for you to land on, so you probably won't fall to your death.
Great.
That thing breaks all the time. Unless something's changed, it won't support much weight.
Come on, up and at him.
Don't push her, Kenny.
Now or never, I guess.
That's my girl. We gotta get that rope down. Mike, you wanna boost her up?
Come on, kid.
Don't let go.
I got you.
Try to hurry, all right? I don't think they're the sharpest guards in the world, but they're no idiots either. They see you not in your bunk, we're all done. Shit, he's coming back. I gotta let you go. I can't stand here. Grab something.
Mm-hmm.
We're in trouble.
Man, you're not gonna believe what I'm looking at. There's gotta be 2,000 or 3,000 of them out there.
In the parking lot?
No, not in the parking lot. I can't see them all, but I see the dust they're kicking up.
So you're not sure?
What, about how many there are?
Yeah.
How can I be?
Fuck. I hope they pass by us.
God, yeah. You think we're ready this time?
I don't know. Bill thinks we are.
Of course he does, but he thought the same thing last time.
We learned a lot since last time.
Is it enough, though?
We'll find out if they turn this way.
Yeah. Yeah.
Crazy about Reggie, huh?
Yeah.
You think Bill...
Go on.
Nah, it's just... I was wondering if you thought Bill maybe...
Spit it out, Hank.
I don't think Bill was gonna let him back in.
Huh. You don't?
No. Do you?
I don't know. So really, no bullshit. You think we're ready?
Yeah, I think so. The homestead, at least. Not sure about the expansion. They're out there just moaning.
That's what they do.
It's driving me crazy. It's really unnerving.
I know what you mean. You figure we'd be used to it by now.
I wouldn't figure that.
You never got used to a light buzzing or anything?
A little different when it's dead human beings walking around.
I'll give you that one.
So what are you doing tomorrow?
Bill wants me to start getting this bay door fixed.
Is that why you're down there?
Yep.
What happened to it again?
Troy backed into it when we brought the prisoners, the new people in.
See, it's hard not to call them prisoners.
Anyway, I'm looking at it now. I don't think we have what we need.
Jesus, really?
We repurposed a lot of shit to get this place built. I can't say for sure if we even had the materials before we started expanding.
I don't know about you, but it seems like we really shouldn't be doing this yet. Shouldn't we just wait until we need more space to make more space?
I don't know, Hank. Bill's got a plan. Look, let's say we call it for now. We'll talk later.
All right, talk to you later.
Yep, later.
Out.
Out.
Psst. You get him? Okay, jump down. I got you. We best get in bed. Troy will be back any minute. Well?
Got him.
Everybody stay where you are. No need drawn suspicion.
That was so cool.
Thank you, Clem.
I told you probably wouldn't die. Nice job.
Thanks.
Yep.
Anyway, get some rest.
I thought about Duck today, about his dumb little face. First things that come to mind are always the dumb things he was doing. Kid was always running in circles. Every damn place he went, he'd just run. He couldn't stop him. Makes it harder to remember he was a good boy. Well, long day tomorrow. One long day.